Hi guys, and welcome back to Sherry Vibes. Today what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell you some tips on how to apply your fragrance and what not to do and how to smell your best. First thing, foremost thing, hygiene. The most important thing in my opinion is hygiene. Shower, fresh clothes, brush your teeth, comb your hair. All of these things first and then come to the fragrance, okay? So shower before a fragrance. Wear washed, ironed clothes so that they don't smell and they don't have anything that can probably overpower your fragrance. Because if you don't have good hygiene, if you are sweating, it's gonna overpower your scent or it's just gonna destroy whatever smell that you are wearing. So I cannot stress this enough. Shower, fresh clothes, brush, or probably do a mouthwash or whatever. You should not smell bad at all. So now coming back to the first tip, you have to know how much is the strength of your fragrance that you are wearing. If you have, for example, if you have just two fragrances, one is a summer fragrance, one is a winter fragrance. Winter fragrances last a long time. They project, they are dominant, they are in-your-face kind of fragrances. Summer fragrances, on the other hand, are not as dominant and you can probably overspray them and they won't kill anybody. For example, I have here a Mancera Cidrat Boise. Now this one is a absolute beautiful fragrance, pineapple based fragrance, not potent at all. Actually it's quite subtle, so you can overspray this one and that won't be a problem. But for example, you're going to wear a Nishane 100 Silent Ways. I had to do that, such a beautiful fragrance. This is a potent fragrance. So if you are going to spray this, there is no way you should over apply this. The second tip is you should know what kind of fragrance you are wearing. Then the third tip on where and how to apply. Now my general routine is 5 to 6 sprays, sometimes 7 sprays. Depend on what I'm wearing, depends on where I'm going. If you're going to the office, don't do too many sprays. If you're going to a party, you can do as many sprays as you want. If you're going to the market, probably a medium 5-6 sprays is okay. If you're going to a date, depends which fragrance you're wearing, don't kill the other person. So my general routine of spraying is I spray here on this part of the shirt. So one very good tip, never spray here or here. What's gonna happen is that the whiff is straight gonna come to your nose. You're gonna have olfactory fatigue and also it's gonna burn and your nose is going to itch. So don't do that. Also for men, putting your fragrance here might just irritate the skin even more. So what I tend to do is I do one spray here, I do one spray here. If I'm going to a party, I do two sprays here also. The ideal thing is to do it on the back of your ear. If you touch here, it's gonna be a little warm also because this is a pulse point. So spraying on the pulse point is really good, and one here. And another thing I usually do is I also spray on the back of my neck. So what this does is when I pass from somewhere, people are going to smell it. Oh, I smell so good. Another very good tip for the ladies, or I think men can also do that, doesn't make a difference. You have freshly washed your hair, probably dried it, and then what you have to do is you take your brush, you spray it with the fragrance and you brush your hair. So what's going to happen is your hair are going to smell the same as your fragrance of the day. But beware, the fragrance will stay on the brush for quite long. It usually stays for a week or so and then it goes away and you can spray something else or you can just wash it. So these were my tips on how to apply. Another thing I've seen people doing, and I have to stress on this one, what people usually do is they spray their hand or their wrist and then they rub it together. No. Never do that. Never. I repeat, never do that. What it's gonna do is it's gonna kill the molecules of the fragrance. Even if you do this or this, you're not going to smell the actual fragrance. you're not going to understand what the notes are, and it's not going to project at all. It's not even going to stay there. So even if you're testing fragrance, never rub it in. Let it sit there on your arm, and if you want to dry it, just dry it out like that. You will also get some whiffs of it, and you will get to know how the fragrance smells when somebody else smells you, and when you pass by that room or that person, how does this one smell? Another thing people usually ask me is how and where to store fragrances. So what I would suggest is to store your fragrances in a cool and dark place. So sunlight is not good for the fragrance. Light in general is not good for the fragrance. So usually you can put it in your cupboard. Moisture is very bad for your fragrance. So never store your fragrance in the washroom. Never in the washroom. Never store your fragrances where it can get some moisture. That is not good for the fragrance. So guys, these were my tips on how to store your fragrance, how to apply your fragrance, and how you can project more. Another thing, if you have a dry skin like me, you can put some non-scented oil or Vaseline or something like that on your skin and then apply it. But it doesn't always work for me. What works for me is putting it on the clothes and reapplying on the skin. So have a nice day. Stay fragrant.